What's up, everybody? It's your boy Swift Creation right here, and we got Swift Jr. right here. Say what's up.
What's up?
Man, super excited today. Finally got my Aaron takes, dual Aaron takes. Look at them bad boys. Ooh-wee, look at that filter right there. That's looking mighty nice there. And we got here my electric drill cutting. I'm gonna be cutting my baby up. I don't wanna do it, but we gotta do it. Anyway, super excited. Definitely can't wait to install these. These are gonna be nice. You guys are gonna watch me install these. I also picked up a new Michelin shift knob and took it to Project Imports in Orange County. They ended up installing it for me. It looks so nice, and it actually helps me shift a lot better. So we're gonna go actually take a look at that right now. Put this stuff up right now. I got my mom's over here screaming and all that. Let's go look at it real quick. Let's go look at her. My mom's GMC Yukon. That's the 370Z right there. Got my auntie's white BMW right there. And that's the Altima, the daily driver. Let's hop in here real quick. Hoo-wee! Look at that bad boy. Don't you just want to kiss it?
That thing goes mighty fine there, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, guys, but that's it.
So, I'm gonna go ahead and move all these cars out the way, park her in the driveway, and then we're gonna get to it. Here we are. Whoo, look at that beautiful V6, looking gorgeous. Look at them dual air intakes. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and get started. I'm gonna explain the best way I possibly can from my knowledge. I've done a lot of research and watch a lot of videos on how to install the intakes, so bear with me, follow me. Let me know in the comments if I said anything wrong or if you guys have any trouble with what I'm saying, whatever. But let's get into it. So the first step is we're gonna disconnect the negative battery, which you see right there. I believe it's a 10 millimeter. Yep. Okay, disconnect that. Lefty loosey, righty tighty. Nice. Ooh, so that's off. Now I'm gonna remove these strut tower. This strut tower. Strut tower brace, however you want to call it. And let's see, it might be a 14. It's a 14. So we got some 14 millimeter bolts, unscrew these. And there's also two clamps right there that you see that you have to unclamp, and that should be good. There we go. Many people say you can uninstall the air intakes without even taking this the strut bar off, but it's a lot easier to take off the air intakes if you remove this, if you remove the strut bar. This one's already loose. Somebody might have. Yeah. Why is this already loose? That's not good. Somebody didn't tighten that down all the way. That's not good. Damn near bought this car used at 31,000 miles. I didn't know, or I might have didn't see it in the video, but this here plastic material here is covering the strut tower. So you want to remove this, and in order to remove that, you want to get rid of these right here. All you gotta do is just pop it up. Clamps right here. Let's see. Yeah, just that little, you just boop, boop. You just pop up each. Then you got another two 14 millimeter bolts. Once you unscrew those, then you just pop them right out. All right, let's move this out the way. Get to the bumper. So, woo, ground is hot. You guys, I'm not sure if you guys can see, but here, might be like a 5 millimeter. bolt, you unscrew, it's all across, all the way across there. You got some bolts here, here, and over here. So got clamps all across here that you're gonna take off. This off too, from what I've seen. Yeah, I have to take it off. You see, it just clamps, you just unplug them. So let's go ahead and get to it. The GoPro just fell? Yeah, I think it just fell. Damn wind. Oh, I didn't scratch it. I'm good. No, I did scratch it. Oh my gosh. Just pay attention, sweaty. Sweaty, sweaty. Corner. In order to put the tubes through, that's gonna be it right there. Take the engine cover off, and looks like 10 millimeter bolts. Pretty easy. Let's get to it. The engine cover off, sitting right there, looking pretty in the sun. So for me, I'm just gonna start from the top, loosen this screw, and then make my way here in the middle and clamp this, and just make my way down. I'm gonna try to save some battery and try to get these both tubes in real quick. I'll let it charge while I get those two tubes in, and then while it's charging, I'll sit for a little bit, take a break, go get the GoPro, and then come back and have you guys watch me
cut the inside of that.
All right, so I'll be back. Whew. All right, guys, I'm back. Man, it was a pain in the butt to get this here. This part, or the stick here, wouldn't go inside and inside the stick here, if that makes sense. So I have to, this tubing here that comes with the package, I had to cut it myself, and practically that's what I did there, and it worked. It's not moving. Tighten up this clamp here, and it worked. Same goes for this side. I didn't want it to fit this part of the tube here. I didn't want it to fit with the tube that was sticking out of this portion here. So I had to cut that, and yeah. That's what took me a while. Got it, and I'm about to start cutting right now. So, let's get into it. Pretty much got it down cut. It's a little rough on the edges, but everywhere this little girl goes, she pick up another obstacle. She was my heart. I don't know the tribe or the fall. The fight is fall. She don't think of me. I thought she wasn't in the end. It's in there. I don't know if she be tucked in there or not like that, but good so far. So turned out I didn't have to relocate the horn. I'm looking at the papers. I was told, you can see a little bent, and I was told to bend it back, so that's pretty good. It's just a tight fit. How long? Hold on, what time is it? So I started at, what does that say, 7:34? Wow. I started at 1 o'clock, so it took me 6 hours. Not bad. Definitely different and harder compared to me when I installed my Aaron Techs on my Ultimate. There was only one outlet, you know, to throttle body. So it was super easy, and it wasn't wrong to have long tube intakes running all the way to the front bumper. It was short ramps, so that was cool. But man, she is nice. Look at this beast right here. I want to thank you guys for watching this video. Please stay tuned for more, guys. Definitely going to provide more videos. I'm about to go take this for a spin. You guys are going to see this in a little bit. Well, right now, actually, in this next clip. Your man Swift is out. Peace out and love.